Super humbling.
All 258 people aboard the jumbo jet died when it exploded and crashed onto the town of Lockerbie.
This morning, the people of Lockerbie are waking up to a continuing nightmare. These scenes of death and destruction bear witness to the sheer horror of this disaster.
A disaster appeal has been set up and has already raised over £50,000.
Probably the first time I remember Lorraine vividly at TVAM was when she reported on Lockerbie. Lorraine's reporting on that was absolutely first class.
Wreckage was scattered throughout the village. This landed just a few feet from nearby houses.
Lorraine was so much the face of it. And the empathy and the sympathy that she showed, I think showed then that what a class broadcaster that she is.
Accident investigators will continue to study the two flight recorders in order to establish the cause of this horrific tragedy.
What Lorraine showed was that she is above all an exceptional journalist.
Police continue their search to try to ascertain what caused this horrific disaster.
I realised then that although she likes to convey an impression of a kind of sweet, benign person, underneath it are some steely journalistic chops.
Lorraine Kelly, TVAM News, Lockerbie.
Because I was doing all the news bulletins, I was on a lot on TVAM at that time, it meant that the editor, Bill Ludford, saw me doing a report and said, get that wee girl down. We need cover, you know, for holidays, get her down. So there's this weird thing of you're getting your big break, if you like, from something so utterly tragic and horrific. So that was quite hard to come to terms with for me, and still is a bit, if I'm honest.
The words Good Morning Britain spelled out by hundreds of people.
You are watching Good Morning Britain from TVM. I'm Mike Morris.
And I'm Lorraine Kelly.
I came down and did the show. I remember being really nervous.
Well, on this morning's programme, we'll be meeting that woman of many parts.
What camera are you looking at? And it was all a bit of a daze, really. But I did enjoy it. But I kept saying, I need to get back to do my job, you know. I need to go back home. And 1 week turned into 2 weeks. And then they just basically gave me the job.
The TVAM logo.
So, after spending 4 years as Scotland correspondent, in early 1989, Lorraine became a familiar face on the TVAM sofa, ultimately settling into her presenting role alongside co-hosts, including Mike Morris.
TVAM, back in the day, you got your news, but you also got fun.
Lorraine was the best at seamlessly bringing it all together, entertaining people whilst giving them information.
TVAM was great because it was pioneering and it was a whole big brand new world, and back then it was an amazing thing to be part of.
Hello and a warm welcome to TVM on Monday, the 1st of June.
I worked with Mike Morris, who was just a delight, you know, he was lovely. All he wanted to do was make a good show. And, you know, he didn't have a massive ego. He was just a good, decent person, perfect for breakfast television. He was kind of every man. You know, he made it very easy for me. It was lovely. It was lovely.
Kylie Minogue's with us this morning. Good morning to you again.
We'd have these amazing guests on because at that time, Terry Wogan had a chat show. Our showbiz people would hang around at the BBC and grab people and say, can you come in tomorrow? You can talk about whatever you like.
Do you think you'd be a good dad?
Yes, let's work on it.
Oh, well.
Jeez, we got people in like Lauren Bacall. I remember interviewing Kirk Douglas.
This one is a bit naughty. It's
naughty?
A bit naughty.
Naughty, she says.
I would phone my mum and go, you'll never guess who's on tomorrow. Sammy Davis Jr. And she's like, ah, away. So, no, seriously. Sammy Davis Jr. is in. Mum, oh, remember and ask him about this film. My mum still does that to me to this day. She still does that. You had Joan Collins on. You should have asked her about, you know, whatever. She's great. She should have her own show, my mum.
Television Centre, London. In the studio, The Lorraine Show is prepping for a record. Lorraine takes a walk along a corridor in her slippers to look at a series of framed photos that line the wall.
This is our rogues gallery of people that I love. My boyfriends. Mr. Hugh Jackman is the nicest man in the world. He's just adorable, so I love that photograph. And he's always a joy to talk to. Legends! Legends. She's great. Really, really good. I love Meryl Streep. He's, again, he's up there. Up there in my... I've got a sort of, like, Tom Hanks, Hugh Jackman are my favourite. Oh, and Ryan Reynolds, I love him.
A-list stars love coming back to see Lorraine because she has a glint in her eye and they know they're going to have a lovely chat. She has that magic power just to make them feel relaxed and enjoy that moment. And if you can make someone enjoy a moment, then you're going to have much more interesting chat with them.
And look who's here. Dolly Parton joins me now. Dolly, it's great to see you.
Well, good to see you too.
So good to see you and looking so well.
Well, thank you. You're fantastic. So complimentary.
George Clooney once sang happy birthday to me during the COVID. I was in my house in my slippers interviewing him. He was in his house in his slippers and it was my birthday and he sang happy birthday.
It's your birthday?
It is my birthday.
Well, they say it's your birthday. That's what we've been told. What a wonderful birthday. You're another year old. On your cake, there'll be candles all coloured. It's true. And the whole world is singing, happy birthday to you.
And I was like, wow, he's lovely. He's a good lad. He's a really nice person.
I don't think George Clooney would ever experience anybody like Lorraine, you know. And I think that's what a lot of people go, wow, this woman's extraordinary because she's not like anybody else.
You're such a good interviewer.
Thank you so much.
You're such a good interviewer. You know you're a good interviewer when it doesn't feel like an interview.
My personal favourite, because I'm a space geek, was Buzz Aldrin.
Buzz, what an honour to talk to you. I was one of the 600 million when I was 10 years old, sitting watching with my dad.
He had a T-shirt on saying, I'm going to Mars, because he still wants to go, and I'll go with him. I think everybody's interesting. Everybody's got a story. And even people that don't particularly like the experience of coming in and being interviewed are interesting. I remember Ralph Fiennes coming in and he hated the whole process.
You don't like doing interviews very much, do you? And yet you're in such a visible job.
We had a brilliant chat about, gosh, isn't it awful that he has to do that to promote his films?
If you ask me, in an ideal world, would I like to do interviews, I'd probably say no.
You know, and we talked about his discomfort and it actually made for a very interesting conversation.
So it's lovely to see you. I wish I could talk to you more and I really wish you all the best with the movie.
And then what's great is when people come in live, it's lovely to go and do an interview, like maybe in a hotel or something. But someone like Kate Winslet comes in, it just lifts everybody, you know. It's very, very exciting. Very exciting.
You're a smashing lady. You're a smashing lady. You're gorgeous. Thank you, Kate. Thank you so much.
Next, a battered Shackleton suitcase, then a penguin ornament in Lorraine's house.
It sounds really silly. I'm not really into the whole kind of whatever a showbiz life is. I don't even know what it is. I'm not the life and soul of the party. But, you know, premieres, I can understand why people want to go, but nah, I'd rather see the movie as a screening and not have to get all done up and go on a red carpet, which is, that to me is hell on earth. Yes. I just love to travel. No makeup, no nothing. You just, I love it. I love that whole, like, exploring and, yeah, just finding out, you know, where's the day going to take you? What are we going to see today? We don't know. To me, that's joy. That's when I'm at my happiest. Every time we go somewhere, we always buy a fridge magnet whenever we can. So this is just covered in some of the places that we've been to. My favourite, Kota Kinabalu, which was brilliant, where we saw the orangutans. And India. Oh, I love India so, so much. We did the ice hotel, which was great, where you actually sleep in ice, but only for a night. That's all you'd want to do. We've got Rajasthan. Then obviously my favourite place here is Orkney. There we are. I'd rather be on Orkney. And away down there, this sign, Twat. Twat is a wee village in Orkney. It's just few houses. And they've got a big sign up that says Twat on it. So obviously everybody gets their picture taken beside the Twat sign.
I think she's always had a great sense of adventure. And I don't think it's necessarily something that comes natural to her in many ways, but it's something that has become natural to her.
Whether it's, you know, in the back of a truck, grubby, in Africa, or up in Orkney, just going for a walk, looking at the puffins. I love that. I love that. I really do.
Lorraine on a hike.